The sorrows of death compass me, and the pains of hell get hold upon me. And in my tribulation I made my prayer unto the Lord, and he regarded my supplication out of his holy temple. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is, like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
Lord, with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord, we beseech thee favorably to hear the prayers of thy people, that we, who art justly punished for our offenses, may be mercifully delivered by thy goodness for the glory of thy name. Through Jesus Christ our Savior, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the ninth chapter of the first epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians, beginning at the 24th verse. Brethren, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run, that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway. Here endeth the epistle. The Lord will be a refuge in the time of trouble, and that they know that thy name that put their trust in thee. For thou, Lord, has never failed them that seek thee. For the poor shall not always be forgotten, the patient abiding of the meek shall not perish forever. Up, Lord, and let not man have the upper hand. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel is written in the 20th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time Jesus spake this parable unto his disciples. The kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is an householder, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers into his vineyard. And when he had agreed with the laborers for a penny a day, he sent them into his vineyard. And he went out about the third hour and saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and said unto them, Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right I will give you. And they went their way. And again he went out about the sixth and ninth hour and did likewise. And about the 11th hour he went out and found others standing idle and saith unto them, Why stand ye here all the day idle? And they say unto him, Because no man hath hired us. And he saith unto them, Go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right that shall ye receive. So when even was come, the Lord of the vineyard said unto his steward, Call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning from the last unto the first. And when they came, that were hired about the 11th hour, they received every man a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more, and they likewise received every man a penny. And when they had received it, they murmured against the goodman of the house, saying, These last have wrought but 1 hour, and thou hast made them equal unto us, which have borne the burden and heat of the day. But he answered one of them and said, Friend, I do thee no wrong. Didst not thou agree with me for a penny? Take that thine is and go thy way. I will give unto this last even as unto thee. Is it not lawful for me to do what I will with mine own? Is thine eye evil because I am good? So the last shall be first, and the first last. For many be called, but few chosen. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things. Powerful, unbelievably strong parable of the laborers in the vineyard. It's very simple what it means. It's just so simple that sometimes we just gloss on over and don't think about how to apply that thing in our lives. The householder is God, okay? That's easy. The laborers, who are they? You and me and all human beings everywhere. Instead of being happy for all the blessings that God gives to us, we succumb to temptation. We turn our back on God's gifts. When we get angry at other people, we don't think about God. You know, the all-day workers were angry when they compared their wages to that 11th hour group, the 11th hour reprieve, huh? That happens in another time in the gospel narrative too. They were angry. Guess what? If you're mad at someone else's happiness, you got a problem. What does it do to the soul? It opens it up to sin. That's what it does. And sin destroys our ability to love. Is thine eye evil because I am good? Isn't that great? Isn't that just a fabulous saying, huh? The evil eye, an expression of jealousy and envy. But, you know, we're 21st century moderns. We think we're elevated in understanding and everything else. So we don't call it an evil eye anymore. We call it the stink eye, huh? You ever see somebody do the stink eye? Or also known as the skunk eye? Or even more kind of gross in 21st century, it's called the hairy eyeball. Isn't that great, huh? Well, it happens to us innumerable times in our life, and it starts really with one when we're kids, because kids kind of emulate us big people. And here's an example of that. Little boy goes and he plays with Jimmy, and Jimmy's got a brand new truck, and so the boy goes back into his house and he says, Mommy, Mommy, Jimmy's got a new truck. I want that. I want one too. You know what that is? That's envy. So we start that way, but then we grow up and we continue doing that, looking at other people, kind of assessing them. And so we say things like, Well, that's a nice pair of shoes you got. And then we think, I should have those things. You know what that is? That's an infraction of the 10th commandment. It's a sin. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's shoes, thy neighbor's house, wife, servant, maid, ox, ass, anything that belongs to your neighbor, just quit looking at it. We look to and concentrate on and get angry about others. And when we do, we lose sight of God altogether. We stop thinking about God. The world is absolutely filled with fallen folk, we know that, and who are so low down that they have dug a hole themselves and jumped into it. Do not fight with them. They'll grab a hold of you and pull you down in the same old dark hole of sin. Pray for them. Do, in other words, what Jesus tells us to do and what he did also. So let's run the race that we heard about in the epistle this day. Hand in hand with Christ as our guide. Let's learn to fight the good fight. Now some would say, or maybe we say periodically ourselves, how can we be so sure of our calling against the powers of darkness? But here's the answer: by focusing on Christ. Because when we are filled with God, in the presence of God, there's no room for the devil. None whatsoever. Guided by the Holy Spirit, we look to no one else in this world. We don't get angry at people. We don't fight with people. We stand up and look and keep our eyes on Christ. Jesus is our path. And today he has given us a glimpse of life in his presence in the parable of the vineyard. You want to receive the crown incorruptible? Don't look to the left or the right or this or that guy or gal. Just keep your eyes on Christ. Follow him into heaven itself. All things come of thee, O Lord.
Thine own have we given.
Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, receive this sacrifice to thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he He brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being holpen by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude, through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, we do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Receive the bread of heaven, call upon the name of the Lord, and it's my strength and my salvation. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. The Lord be with you. Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.